So this week's video is going to be a little different. I thought I'd bring you along for some of my Thanksgiving prep. We are going to my brother's house for Thanksgiving, and I have aunt and uncle coming in tomorrow, Wednesday, that are going to be visiting and then having Thanksgiving with us. But yeah, I just thought, you know, my channel's Home Sweet Home Farmhouse, and the main focus right now is the restoration of my farmhouse, but kind of part of who I am and why I even care about restoring a farmhouse kind of comes down to some more basic life things. I really like simplifying life, and doesn't mean that it's easier, but like going back to like our roots, like what our ancestors, our grandparents, our great grandparents, how they lived life, you know, cooking things from scratch, using all the ingredients as much as possible, you know. When you have a turkey or a chicken, to save the bones and to make broth and make soup with that. To use the scraps from veggies and give them to your chickens, and just some of those things that really are kind of the inspiration behind my desire to have my own farmhouse. So yeah, I thought it might be fun to share that with you. If you watch this week's video and you're like, nope, absolutely not, this is not the kind of content I want to see, then please leave a comment below. And I will not do more videos like this. But if you enjoy seeing a little piece of my life aside from restoration, I will keep doing that. I do hope to get out to my house on Friday or Saturday, or maybe both. It's supposed to be above 35. So definitely a lot more manageable temperature than it was last week, the day I went out. So yeah, hoping to actually be able to get some work done and not even have to worry about finding my space heater that it seems to have gone missing. So yeah, thanks for watching, and please leave a comment if you like this, if you don't like it, and be sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that. All right, thanks. So I'm just getting started on our stuffing. So for years, my mom and I have made our own stuffing. We used to buy Pepperidge Farm stuffing that's just the breadcrumbs or bread cubes. But the last, I don't know, probably 4 or 5 years, we've switched to using sourdough bread. So this year I have a variety of bread cubes that we've made from our own sourdough bread, a couple different batches of bread. Usually if we have like a few slices at the end of a loaf that are getting dry, or sometimes I've had a loaf that doesn't rise the way we want it to, it's not as nice for eating fresh as toast. So cube that up, put it on a cookie sheet, and you can put it in a low temperature oven, or sometimes when we're running our wood stove, we'll just set it on top of there and let it dry. So that is the start of our stuffing. So we've got our bread cubes here, and then I'll show you what else we add to it.
So here's our ingredients for the rest of the stuffing. We have a stick of butter. So we will saute the onions and the celery in that. We'll chop those up first, or slice them up, depending on what they are. And then we'll add the pork sausage and brown that, and then all of that gets added to our bread cubes. And then we've got a jar of home canned chicken broth, but obviously you could use any chicken broth. And then once it's cooled off a little bit, then we'll add in our eggs.
Putting together our pumpkin pie, and I'm gonna make a double batch, and either make 2 regular pies, or I might make it in a 9x13. I haven't decided yet, but I think sometimes people are intimidated by making pie, but really, it's, to me, it's easier than a lot of desserts.
that you can make. So, or just as easy, maybe not easier, but it's not a lot more labor intensive or time intensive than making cookies or a cake. Actually, cookies are not my favorite thing to make because it takes a long time because you have to keep making more and more cookie balls. So, but yeah, the pumpkin, I think I showed you that before, is actually buttercup squash that we grew in the garden this summer. And then I just whipped it up in the mixer before this, so it's nice and smooth at this point. So now I'm just getting things measured out. I don't have pumpkin pie spice, so I'm just gonna use a mix of nutmeg and cloves for that part of it. I need to use ginger too. Almost forgot that. So it calls for 2 teaspoons of pumpkin pie spice for a recipe. So I will probably use 1 teaspoon of ginger and then like 3/4 teaspoon of nutmeg and 1/4 teaspoon of cloves. And I have used different recipes for pumpkin pie different years. A lot of times I'll pull out our old Betty Crocker cookbook and look at theirs. This year I decided to try, I don't know if you're familiar with Farmhouse on Boone, the channel here on YouTube, but Lisa has a recipe for pumpkin pie, so I decided to give hers a try. One thing that I always look for at this point for pumpkin pie is one that uses heavy whipping cream instead of like condensed milk or something. I really like how whipping cream or heavy cream, how the results are with that. So that is one thing that I look for in a pie recipe for pumpkin pie. Let me make sure I've got everything. Oh, the cream. And then I think the only other thing is the ginger. So I'm gonna grab that really quick here. So you might notice a lot of our things are in jars. We go through a lot of things because we bake a lot. And so we like to buy in bulk rather than buying small jars of things, so. And I know some people have concerns about like spices and herbs, like losing their flavor. For the most part, we don't have that issue. We've maybe had some like basil or oregano that kind of loses some of its flavor, but then you just use a little more. But I feel like that was in the past. We didn't use as much. We use herbs more than we used to. And I don't have enough cream here, so I'll have to go get some more. But that's pretty much it. I'll show you what it looks like when it's all mixed up. And then once we get it baked.
So here's the finished pie, ready to go in the oven. I didn't do anything too fancy with the edges. This is my first time doing a pie in a 9x13-inch pan like this. But yeah, you can see it looks like it worked pretty good, so we're gonna get it in the oven and get it baked. So one thing I like about farmhouse living and what I hope to see someday at my house is to maybe have some chickens. But because things don't go to waste, you know, like scraps from today, the ends of cucumbers and just random things, you know, they're put to good use, and I like that. Not waste the things that we have and also be more self-sufficient. Well, it's 5 o'clock here and it is now dark, but we're still working away. Took a little break this afternoon. And now I'm getting ready to work on our Guilt Begone cranberry pie. Basically it's a low carb pie. So
The oat fiber is not a carb, and then it's this sweetener pure, which is a stevia blend. So yeah, I'm gonna get working on that. So there's our Guilt Be Gone cranberry pie. Took me less than 10 minutes to throw that together, so definitely a great option for the busyness of the holiday season. Happy Thanksgiving. We just stopped by my house on the way to our family gathering. My aunt and uncle are in town from Wisconsin this week and they wanted to check out the house, so we just came a few minutes early to do that. But it is a beautiful day. It's in the 30s and I'm still hoping to get out here probably Saturday and get some work done. It's supposed to be nice then too, but I hope you all had a wonderful Thanksgiving day and are enjoying this week's video. All right, bye. Hello, it is Saturday afternoon and I am over here at the house. I think it's just about 40 degrees or maybe even warmer than that. If it wasn't windy, it would be even warmer, or it would feel warmer. But yeah, so today I'm just trying to work on this project of getting my windows covered with plastic. So on the front of the house where I got everything painted, that side's all watertight now, except the windows. Some of the windowsills are rotten and things like that. And so to keep it from getting any moisture in the house on that side, my plan is to cover it with clear plastic, which is in this box here behind me. So I'm hoping I can get those windows done on the front of the house today. Hopefully it doesn't take terribly long. I think I've got a pretty good plan for how to do it, but yeah, we'll see how it goes.
All right, so my plan I've got a roll of clear plastic, a pretty thick mill that I bought from the, it's a 4 mil thickness. Now it says clear, it looks kind of white right at the moment, but obviously that's not the end of the world for what I'm doing. I don't have to be able to see out my windows perfectly. I have a feeling it's gonna be wider than I need. But my plan is to staple it to staple it to my lath here and then kind of roll it a couple of times and staple it again. And then I will nail that above the window frame and then just staple down the sides of it. So hopefully that gives us what we need. So let's see what we got. So I thought I would show you a quick example of what I meant by how the window sills are rotten. This one here is a really good example. You can see it's just rotted pretty much straight through. The rest of the window isn't in bad condition, but obviously there's been moisture sitting there and just causing it to rot. So then I'll show you, I have one window done here on the front of the house and just show you kind of what that looks like. You know, you saw me stapling it to the lath. So here at the top, just have it right under one of the boards of the siding so that the rain just drips off of it, doesn't get stuck in there. And then stapled down the sides. I did fold it over just so that it had a little more to grip to. Hopefully that keeps it from ripping. And then at the bottom again, just wrapped it in some lath and then nailed it down. So I think it's doing the trick. So it went up pretty smoothly, I felt like, but I might do a few things different on the one up higher. One thing is that I had it stapled to the top piece of lath and turned over, but I didn't do that on the bottom, and I think that would have made it a lot simpler. So at least I think so. So with this next one up high, that's what I'll do, and hopefully that makes it a little easier. But yeah, it went on pretty quickly. So we'll get that other one done. And then hopefully the three smaller windows like the one I just showed you. So yeah, I think it's working the way I hoped it would. So that's good.